The soundboard in a violin amplifies the sound. To be able to do that, it has to have a really broad resonance curve so that it can amplify as many frequencies as possible. For this reason, we can look at the nodes as we make oscillate this plate on a speaker. It's actually a driven oscillation at a certain frequency that you can see here and at a certain amplitude that I'm outputting from this function generator. And as I change the frequency, we will see different behavior of the sand that I'm sprinkling on top of this plate. The plate is called a Chladni plate, spelled C-H-L-A-D-N-I. That's named after Ernst Chladni, a German physicist. And he shows you pretty much the same thing as a string does in two dimensions with bellies and nodes. A Chladni plate does, the string does in one dimension with bellies and nodes. A Chladni plate does in two dimensions with areas that are bellies and nodes, like on the surface of a drum, for example, or the soundboard of a violin. It's not exactly identical to a violin for two big reasons. The first is that this is actually the size of a viola, not a violin. And the second reason is that it's actually supported on a post at the center. And that's not where the sound post is on a violin or a viola like this. It's actually off center. It's close to the bridge, but not quite under the bridge, and so on. So these are, with these two key differences in mind, we can see if I give it more amplitude that it starts, that the sand starts bouncing up and down. And as I change the frequency, the pattern of nodes and bellies where the sand accumulates and moves away, accumulates in nodes, moves away from bellies, continues to change. I'm around 400 hertz above it. So I said that the center of vibration here is where this post is that's moving up and down as a with a speaker underneath it. That's centered here in an actual instrument is not. So all of these patterns are kind of symmetric now. They are less symmetric than this in a real musical instrument. I keep going up with the frequency. I'm gonna add a little bit of sand and making it change in yet another completely different pattern. You notice it gets louder and less loud as I go away from that resonance. And so louder here and less loud just above or just below. So it has a particular place where it resonates very strongly, but it's by no means the only one. There are very many of these positions in frequency. That's another one that's very clear here, where the bellies are the biggest, the loudness we perceive is the greatest, and therefore the pattern of nodes is most evident in the sand. I keep going, increase the amplitude as the frequency is higher. And I'm gonna leave it at that. Thank you.